Howdy, all fellow farmers, and good morning. Welcome to the farm. Let's get to work. Let's see, at the end of the last video, we were working on selling the wheat we had harvested. I got it sold, and I'm not sure what was going on. I think it's still happening. I don't know what it is. I know they came out with an update to the map, and it didn't seem to have anything to do with it sinking into that sell point particularly. And I didn't see anything about it. It was just like a few fixes that I guess maybe people had pointed out, something like that. But let's see, what do we want to do? We need to bale that straw, but I think it'd be easier if we ran to the store and got a rake and raked it first. Because I know when I used to be working on the other farm, people kept telling me that I needed to make sure to get rake and rake it first. The store is up north, so I need to make a right out of here. Alright, so we made it to the store. Let's go. Nope, that's not what I want to do. This one? Yeah. Alright, so we need, let's see, that one is 17,000 for 8.2 meters. Whoop. There we go. 17,000 for 8.2 meters. Windrower. This one's $32,000, which we could barely afford. Let's just go with the other one. Go with this one. Because we don't need anything real big, obviously. Where did it drop? There. We don't need anything real big because none of the fields on here seem to be like really, really like humongous or anything like that. So we'll just kind of stick with some of the smaller stuff. I want to get a big farm going. So if you guys know of a big farm I can work on. I like the big farms. I downloaded one yesterday that I was looking at, and it looked really cool, but then when I logged into it and got to looking at it, there were 235 fields. Now, that doesn't mean that, I mean, it was a full map, like full map. But all the fields were like smaller than these, pretty much. But there were 235 fields on the map, which is just insane. I don't know that I even want to work on 235 fields in multiplayer. I mean, I think that would just be crazy trying to do. Whoa, jumping in. Alright, so I got my rake on the ground. We're going. We're getting with it. Get some raking done. We can rake it, and then we can bale it, and then we'll probably just sell the bales. We don't need any, plus the other field that we have over there is barley. So if we want to save some, we can save some from that field. Let's see. I always try to decide what the best way to do is as far as raking, like manually raking like this. But I normally find it best to go up and back, like do that. And then in the end, you just kind of do one pass all the way around the outside. And that'll pretty much get all your straw up, and then the outside row is the one, you know, what you bale last, basically. It seems to work. I don't know. It may not be the best thing, but basically the last thing you do is a headland, pretty much. So I did the back and forth. Now I'm doing the last headland. And I'm going to be cutting out, hopefully not a lot, but, you know, at least right now, we need to be getting a bunch of stuff done on the farm, and honestly, I don't know that the videos need to be, like, 45 minutes or whatever, because I know some people won't want to watch 45 minutes. I always ask for opinions on stuff like that, you know, do you guys want it longer, shorter, whatever, just because I would like to know what people want to watch. But, you know, I'm going to try to do videos that I know people are going to watch. Or that at least people, you know, people are going to be willing to sit down for that amount of time and, you know, sit there and watch videos, you know, that the butcher man's making. So we're trying to entertain people. We're trying to entertain the masses on the Butcher Man channel. So if you got any gripes or complaints, there's a comment box below. Go ahead and fill it out and let me know. And we'll deal with it as it comes. Deal with it together. Now we got it raked up. Now we need to drive back over to the farm and get the baler. And let's see, pretty much everything's, you know, pretty much all the work is going to be done with this one tractor. And it's kind of unfortunate, but right now we don't even have, we have one other tractor, but you know, there's no power. You know, the tractor has nothing to it. Which I suppose it could have ran the rake. You know, it's got enough power to run the rake. I don't think I'd trust it to run the baler necessarily. Can't really see that. It's almost a blind corner or blind turn. Whoa, what happened? I don't know what happened there. I think my rake maybe got stuck or something. I was turning, but it wasn't turning. I was turning back to the left and it just kept going to the right. That's weird, because these are both like, you know, stock equipment or whatever you want to call it. Original farm and sim equipment. I don't know why they'd be having troubles. Maybe I need to call the dealer. Call the dealer about the rake and just tell him there's problems. Let's see, that's not the baler, that's the bale trailer. We ought to put the rake back there by the bale trailer, though, probably. Make this turn? Yeah. We'll just put it over here by the bale trailer. Then we'll come over here and get our baler. I don't know how many bales we'll get off that field, but we're going to try to get, you know, as many as we can. That way we can make a little bit of money. Because that cash is just, you know, it's very short when you're starting out on a farm. And we got a little bit of a loan to the bank. I can't remember how much we owe the bank. Okay, we only owe them $50,000. We're going to try to leave it at that. I don't want to take out any loans. We may be able to call the store and rent some equipment at some point if we need something special, but hopefully we can kind of do the work and kind of keep up with what we need. Kind of keep up enough profit. Prices on grain are always pretty good down at the store. We got two different stores we can go to. Whoop. Come on, traffic. And if you'll notice, the traffic is moving a little slower than it was. I did uninstall the game and reinstall the game to try to get like the graphical glitches fixed, but it doesn't seem as though it did that, which, you know, I don't know, maybe you guys can't see it, maybe I'm the only one that can see it, but I know when I look at my screen over there, look at OBS, I can see it over there. I'm assuming that means you guys can see it. If you don't see any like graphical glitches or anything like that, just let me know. I need to go back in and change the traffic speed though. If I can remember how to do that. I might have to look up how to do it again. I know it's something about going in and taking the car's XML file out and replacing it with the faster traffic car's XML. Something like that. Alright, let's see. I do suspect these will all roll down the hill. But that's okay. We'll deal with it when it gets there. Why are you not turning? I feel like I'm getting a bit of lag or something. I don't know if you guys will see it, but I know when I was raking, there's a spot over there that's messed up, but I was going. And then all of a sudden the game just like glitched out, like I wasn't doing anything. Like the tractor started going up ahead and it wasn't raking or like that. And I don't really know what was wrong with it. Go ahead. Keep going. That's the main thing I don't like about the round baler. Is the fact that you have to stop. You know, you gotta stop and you gotta unload it and all that good stuff. But overall, it's pretty good. I mean, the fact that you can bale the grass and then wrap it. like bale the hay and wrap it and then it turns into silage. That's real nice. Is this gonna, I think that field or that gate, that fence should have collisions. Guess we'll find out in a minute, won't we? That bale goes through the fence, then we got problems. If it just hits the fence, as long as it doesn't break it, then we should be fine. If it damages the fence, then we've got to go repair fence later. I don't know if you guys know anything about repairing fence, but I am like a professional fence repairman. I have done my fair share of rewire and some stuff. I've worked on a couple of farms in my day. See, there was a graphical glitch. You see that? No? Okay. Cool. Let me know. Ooh. That one filled up pretty quick. I think the fact that the yield was low, we're not going to get as many bales. We're only up to 4, which 4 is still pretty good, I think. I mean, it's not a lot, and the bales won't sell for a whole lot, but we will take what we can get, I think. Obviously, we can't take any more than what we can get, because that's impossible. We really hope that what we're going to do, let's see, this was wheat, so we need to turn it to barley. We're going to need to cultivate. I guess we got to cultivate it no matter what, because we don't have one of the fancy seeders yet. It will take us a little while to cultivate it, because we got the little cultivator. And right now, we just cannot afford to upgrade. We could probably rent a cultivator. We could probably sell that one and rent one. But I don't think we're going to do that. I think we're just going to stick with it. And it's going to be a pain. But it's been so long since I played Farm Sim that, you know, since I've done any farming on here, it might be alright. Might just be alright. I guess we'll find out, won't we? What just happened? That is so weird. I swear that's got to be like a glitch of some kind or something. I'm at the end of the row, aren't I? I don't know what that was. I got no idea. You guys kind of see that? Like, it's sort of like spaced out. And you can see the camera even back up a little bit. And then it even turned around the other direction. That was weird. I've never seen Farm Sim do that. I don't know. I'm really thinking about clearing my mods folder. You know, especially like right now, we don't have any mods. I mean, we're running like a few of them, like the Inspector mod, and like this map is a mod, and like a few things, but nothing major. You know, nothing that would really get us in trouble. So I think I might just like clear my mods folder. Just clean it out completely. Get rid of everything. Oh, it's not done yet. I thought it was done. Just get rid of everything. And then kind of just start from scratch. I hate doing that, but I have a lot of, like, I probably have, you know, 200-400 mods in my folder. I mean, it is crazy how many are in there. But I probably just need to wipe it all and then just download only what I need for this map. And then if I want to use a different map, I'll just, you know, download what I need for it, and that'll be it, man. So we may be missing a few things. We're probably going to I might keep all the John Deere stuff. That might be the only stuff I keep is the John Deere stuff. I might take it out separate and then delete everything else or something. I really hate deleting all my mods, though, because I've got, like, a bunch of them that, you know, it takes so much to download mods sometimes. You gotta go through so much of a fight. But I just don't know what's going on with my game. You know, I don't know what's going on with it. It's like acting up and stuff. Let's see. Got a little bit up here we'll pick up. We're at 24%, so we ain't gonna finish no bale, but there was a little in the corner there I think I didn't get. Might as well grab it, because it's gonna be baling that other field as well, so. Alright, how many did we get? 12. We dropped 12 on the ground. So let me go get the bale trailer, the bale pickup trailer. Get that dropped off. Get her backed in there like a pro. Then we'll go over here and get this trailer. How many did I say we got? 12? I think this holds 8. I do believe. I do know that you sell the bales at the stable. Can't remember where that is now. Like it's... Can't remember. I know we looked around. I know we found it. I just don't remember where it is. What is that yellow square? Is that my house? I don't know. These cars ain't too slow. They're not too bad. I think I could deal with this. I don't know. I'll probably see if I can't speed them up, because they're kind of a nuisance sometimes when you get trying to get in a hurry and stuff. I do think this farm is going to end up turning into John Deere, just like the other farm we had. The court, I think it's Court Farms. I think is what we had, all John Deere. The Willow Tree Farm is probably going to be all John Deere. I need to look up, too, about the graphical glitches. Somebody might have an answer for that. I thought it was if your graphics are turned down too low, then it's like your graphics card's trying to catch up or something like that. Ooh, that's bad. My bad. But I've got the graphics turned up. I turned them all up, and that's when it started doing that funky stuff with the... not being able to take the screenshots. So I turned the one thing down. I don't directly remember what it was, but I did turn one thing down. Now, I'm still having the screen tearing, even though I reloaded, like, unloaded, or... And there's that. What is that about? You see that? How it just kind of took off, and it's like I was stuck in one place and I couldn't really do anything. That's crazy. I've never had that issue before. I don't know. I'm going to have to rely on you guys if you know anything about it. If you've heard anything around the water cooler, as they say. If I can remember where the stables are. Do our look around trick right quick. I don't want to be searching around all over the place. That's the store. That's where you sell your pigs and beef. That's the biogas plant. Where are we at here? There's a stable. How do I get there? Can I just go this way? Yeah. Yep. I can go over here, take a left, take a left, take a... Can I go from this way too? Am I getting lost somehow? No, that just goes to a field. And that field goes to nowhere. Alright, so there's only one way to get there then. Let's get her on then. Let's get it on. So I was looking through my analytics today because I was watching a YouTube video and the guy kept talking about his analytics. And I got to discovering that most of my subscribers seem to be from the United States now. And most of my views seem to be coming from the United States now, which is, you know, doesn't really make that much of a difference to me. It's whatever. But I also got to looking at videos and views and what videos have gotten more views or whatever. And it seems as though my most viewed video is my Sandy Bay Gold Edition update. And I think, if I remember right, it's got like 2,600 views or something crazy on it. Which is just insane. At least on my channel, that's insane. It's like the video I posted that went up today, this morning, I think when I got home from work it only had like 8, but then in a couple of hours it had like 12. And is this it? This is it, ain't it? Need to open the gate though. Alright, let's get in here. Get in here. Can't remember what button it is. Is it O? Yeah. It's O to unload. Alright, let's see how much we get. I can't remember how much you get for bales. Was it even worth it to buy the rake? Let's see, we got 18,000, 20,000, so that's 280 a piece times 8. Oh, there's the thing again. How much do we pay for that rake? Is it a lot? $17,000. That means it's going to take like 9 loads of bales just to pay for the rake. That's crazy. Man, it takes a lot of work on a farm. You guys believe that? The farming takes work. Who knew? I didn't know. I'm gonna have to pay attention. We don't want to get in a wreck around here. This is a nice looking map, though. I think he did do a real good job. Got a lot of grass fields. We could probably plow a lot of these under if we want to. It seemed like the fuel is going down really quick. Or maybe that just have a smaller fuel tank. You gotta look both ways before you pull out. These traffic people are crazy. How is there a car behind me already? That was fast. He probably came out of the woods. They just come out of the woodworks around here sometimes. No, nothing you can do about it. Oh, bumps. Oh, I'm gonna hurt my back doing that sort of stuff. I've gotta slow down, man. Getting too old. Getting too old for some of this stuff. I don't really know how much we'll get done today. We'll probably get at least a little bit of cultivating done. I don't think we'll get all of it done. Because I don't want to cut out too much. I want you guys to hang out with me the whole time. You know, and experience the farm life. The real life work goes into it. I mean, this ain't real life work. I mean, realistically, I don't think one of these trailers exists. But we're going to go with it does. I think what we're going to do is instead of hassling with taking this down and selling it, since it's so far, I think we're just going to take this trailer and we're going to park it back at the barn. Because it's only half full. We don't want to waste extra fuel taking a half a load of bales down there. We can always do it later. We'll head back to the barn and we'll get the cultivator and we'll bring her out. Now that we got that parked, I got to thinking about it. We don't have a fertilizer spreader or sprayer or nothing. So before we cultivate it, we need to fertilize it. Can't necessarily be doing all that, you know. We don't really want to cultivate it if it ain't got no fertilizer on it. If you fertilize it first and then cultivate it in, it makes a big difference. Cause you don't want to like cultivate it and then fertilize it and then put the seed on it. Am I going the wrong way? I am going the wrong way, aren't I? Leave it up to me, man. Go and whip a Yui here. Get in behind this van. Let's go, van. We pass. He's just driving way too slow. We're going to pass him. Good? Ooh, about not good. We're running into a car. Alright, pull up here to the store. Run over here to the thingy. What's up, Bill? I need a fertilizer spreader, bud. We'll go ahead and get that. In there. And it's over there. I don't think there's any fertilizer fillers here. He's not gonna fill it for me. Ain't that just the nicest person to Bill? He's gonna not even fill it up for me. Got $6,000 left. We'll see how much it costs to fill the fertilizer buggy. Fertilizer filler spreader thingy. Now we are gonna have to also fill the cedar. Cedar's not real big. To catch traffic, and some of them turns you can't really see it. Gotta do the best we can though. Do the best you can with what you got. Look at that, you can actually see the tractor like dipping down in the back. That is so cool. You can see it getting heavier. Is that not the coolest thing ever? I mean, I'm just super surprised by these video games these days. How awesome they are. Because like that right there, I mean, it could tell. Like it was increasing, like, you know, you could see the back of the tractor kind of lowering down as the amount of fertilizer went up. You know, and if you were to stop the fertilizer from going in like halfway or something like that, the tractor would stop going down. That's just crazy. And it may not seem crazy to some of you guys, but it seems crazy to me. I ain't completely backwards, y'all, but I'm not as technologically advanced as some people. Okay. You're fairly new to the Butcher Man channel. First off, subscribe. And then hit the like button and all that good stuff. But if you're fairly new to the Butcher Man channel, you ought to know. Go back and watch all my videos. I'm not real great sometimes. You know, the editing software I have isn't real good. And I do the best I can with it. But it's not real great. And I'm not real... I've thought about buying new stuff. But, man, it's so expensive. So expensive for all that garbage. But we'll make do with what we got. Don't know how wide this is. We'll just go and we'll assume it's going to be a decent job. We'll just do what we can with it. Should be spreading, I think. Yeah, look at her. She's doing good. I think what we'll do is we'll go down here at the end and we'll just turn around and go straight back up the hill. Go like this, and we'll drive over here. Is that the line? Wow, that was really far over. We'll just do it about the same way. We'll do it this way. I mean, this will not be as efficient as if I was outside the cab and going third person, but I think this just looks so much cooler. We'll try to do this from now on. Not all the time, obviously, because some people do like the whole outside the cab thing, but I much rather prefer this. Gives it a little more realism and all that good stuff. See that? I bumped my weight. You guys didn't see that. Didn't even happen. I'll bet if we do this, kind of go down this way, then we should be able to just... I might be covering. That covering? Let's have a look. Not 100%, but it'll be close enough, I think. I don't think I'd rather be wasting any more fertilizer doing just that little bit I missed. See, like that right there. That's so weird. Is that not weird? That seems weird. I've never seen it do that before. Let's just run up here real quick and see what I missed. Not a lot, like a little bit here. And if I just kind of turn and go like this, we'll be good. We're good. I've never seen Farming Simulator lag. And it can't be my computer, I don't think. Maybe it's the fact that I got the graphics turned up. I might turn them back down to where they were previously. I don't really know what's going on. You guys know, let me know. Holler at me. That's good. I didn't cut nobody off. See that in the rear view? There's nobody back here. I mean, there's a car back here, but it's a little ways back. Alright, so we got the cultivator hooked on. And we're going to head back down to the field. And I don't know... I don't think we'll be getting to all the field today. But we got the straw raked up, we got the straw baled, and then picked up and sold. And then bought a fertilizer spreader. And then, whoa, car. Man, I can't see. You like sit so far back in the tractor you can't see. But yeah. And then we got bought a fertilizer spreader, we got the field fertilized, so we're going to do a little bit of cultivating. See how much of that we can get done in a little bit. Probably maybe half the field, something like that. And that way we leave a little bit of work for tomorrow. Actually, obviously, there's always work for tomorrow, but I'm just saying. We'll leave some cultivating for tomorrow, maybe. I don't know. Maybe we'll get it all today. You guys just hang in there, man. We'll get her. We'll get her going. As I get turned in here. Is it gonna pull it? It sure looks like it's gonna pull it. Yeah, we're pulling it. We're pulling it right nice. Right through the grass. I always like to do this right when I get a new farm. You never know how far the grass goes over. Is this killing the grass? No, it's not killing it. I don't know. Well, this has been an awful lot of work. A lot of back and forth, up and down, to and fro, and turning around and stopping and raising and lowering and all that good stuff, but Almost done. Almost done. And hopefully, as long as all goes well, I always hate to count on it, but as long as everything goes as planned, you guys will have just watched, you know, this awesome, you know, musical montage, whatever, of me going really fast, and then it slows down, and all this, you know, theatrical good stuff. So, if you like that sort of stuff, give me a thumbs up. But if it didn't actually happen, then my bad. My apologies. I do try, but, you know, sometimes my equipment, sometimes my software doesn't really correspond with what I want it to do. Like, I use Windows Movie Maker or whatever up in the barn. And, yeah, sometimes you go to cut a piece of video, and then instead of cutting it, it'll copy it, or it'll delete it, or it'll something. It doesn't always cut it like it's supposed to. You hit cut, and then it just something else. But I don't know. Man, we're like 147 liters. This was a lot of work, though. A lot of work for this little tractor. I do think, just to see if it fixes the graphical glitches and the freezing, because the only thing I can explain that whole, you know, the tractor taking off without me thing, that's got to be lag in Farm Sim. And pretty much from what I've always learned and what I've always known for Farm Sim is that if you got a problem with it, it's probably a mod. There's probably some kind of mod conflict or whatever going on. And so it's almost always in your mods folder. So, yeah. Where'd I go? I'm like going off course trying to take a picture. All these selfies, man. All these selfies. A lot of people take selfies. I take selfies, but only on Farm Sim. Or only on the internet, I guess. I don't really do selfies in real life because I have a flip phone. I don't do selfies because I don't have a purpose to even see myself on my phone. And I don't do snap crap, and I don't do pictogram or pictochat or whatever, all that stuff people send to each other. And so I don't really need it. But look at that. That's a job well done. Missed a couple of spots, but I think we can say that's good for now. Head back to the farm. Run over to the barn, we'll park this thing, we'll take a pickup back to the truck, and we'll have a good old night. We'll call it a day. Go get some rest. Take a bit of a nap, maybe catch back up with it tomorrow when you come out here and seed it. Maybe if we let that fertilizer sit in there overnight and then we seed it, maybe it'll help out a little bit. I don't know. Maybe tomorrow we can do some seeding, and then as long as the seeding don't take forever, which I suppose it won't take that long. It'll probably take about as long to seed it as it did just now to cultivate it. But it depends on how many trips we got to make back to the barn to get seed. Because our seeder's not real big just yet. So depending on that, we'll get that field seeded, and then we'll probably go harvest that other field. And hopefully we can get all that done. There's always plans. There's always my plans, and there's always, you know, the game's plans. The game's plans don't always line up. Let's put this in front of this plow. Plow ain't really going to come in handy just yet. Go and hook that. Where's my fuel tank? We always like to fill up the tractors and stuff before we park them. You know, that way tomorrow when I jump in it, I'm not like, man, I got all this stuff I want to do. Oop, there's a fuel tank. You don't jump in it and go, oh, there's so much stuff I want to do, but I've got to fill it up with fuel. Because I didn't do it yesterday. We'll jump out. You need to stop your engines when you fuel up your tractor. Doodly 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 do. Can you hear it? Can you hear it? Sounds like it's almost done. Almost? Click. There we go. Yeah, all right, let's go park this. I did move my pickup, if you guys didn't notice, or did notice, or whatever. I did move my pickup. We'll go ahead and park this right in here. How's that? Because we're going to be seeding tomorrow anyway. We'll just fill the seeder then. How's that sound? Need to wash that thing at some point. Do I already own a pressure washer? Don't even know. No, I don't. Maybe we'll get one at some point. Maybe. Oh, that was a bit of lag and freezing and stuff. Alright, let's head this thing back over to the house. I appreciate you guys coming and stopping in and spending the day with me. Doing some work on the farm. It's always pleasant. It's always pleasant, you know. If you guys much enjoyed hanging out with the butcher man, go ahead and hit my like button down there. Really appreciate it. If you're new to the channel and you really enjoy the content, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and it'll let you know when I upload more videos. But overall, I think it was a very successful day. We got some stuff done. We did a bit of work on the farm, and tomorrow we do some more work. So just hang in there. Stay tuned. And I'll be back tomorrow. This is the Butcher Man saying good day, y'all, and happy farming.